Good day, my friends. This is Easy Engineering, and today's topic is all about the intensive and extensive properties. Intensive and extensive properties are two general classes of thermodynamic properties. These terms are introduced by Richard C. Tolman in 1917. In simplicity, these terms are used to identify if the certain property depends on the amount of material present in that body, or what we call as mass. As what the definition says for each of it, intensive property is a property dependent of the amount of mass, whereas extensive property is a property that is dependent of the amount of mass. So first, let's talk about the intensive property. Intensive property, as what the definition says, is a property independent of the amount of mass. It means that it will not change if its mass gets lessened or added. Here are examples of intensive properties: color, temperature, odor, pressure. So take a look of this orange rock. Imagine having a temperature of 40 degrees Celsius, as it may be standing on a tropical place somewhere. Anyway, let's divide this rock into two and see what happens. The rock is still in its same color orange, and same temperature, 40 degrees Celsius. And that's what it means when we say intensive property. So now, let's go to the other one, the extensive property. Extensive property is a property dependent of the amount of mass, which means that it will change if its mass gets lessened or added. Now, examples of extensive properties are total volume, length, weight, mass. So let's go back again to that first example, the color orange rock. Let's divide it again into two and see that the total volume has definitely changed, and of course the length has changed as well. So that's it. But before we end this video, let me ask you this question: is a boiling point of water intensive or extensive property? Yes, my friend, it's intensive property, as it is not dependent on mass. In fact, it depends on pressure. A boiling point of water at sea level, where it has a pressure of 101.325 kilopascal pressure, is 100 degrees Celsius. But if it's on higher elevation, where for example on a mountaintop having a pressure of 50 kilopascal, the boiling temperature becomes 81 degrees Celsius. So that's all for today. I hope you guys have learned something for this topic. And once again, this is Easy Engineering.